I'm going to ask for directions.
No, no, you mustn't. The city is full of criminals. We can't let them know we're vulnerable. Fine. We'll just stand here until you remember the way, shall we?
Blackets will be done.
Right. Until you remember the way, shall we?
Such a curious artifact. So small and seemingly harmless, and yet it contains so much.
Still breathing, despite everything.
Such a curious artifact. So small and seemingly harmless, and yet it contains so much.
Thank you. also has...
We are not
exactly
in
pleasure
a brothel.
Pleasure isn't just physical, it's a state of mind.
The lips, the tongue. If your mighty Mars, you will...
Let's go to Khan's garden.
I got it. And thanks.
It'll make you feel better.
It's perfect for a Gortat invented the steel watch?
This armor was...
No, he merely offered patronage. The Gondians built...
How about we settle on...
Don't mind if I do.
Come on.
Essence breeds madness. There's no time to waste. No chance I'll fit through that.
I brought my own paring knife. Now I just need some ingredients, and I'm gonna make something really good, I promise.
Always makes my day better.
My friend, now we have settled the matter of the guild, I fear there is something I must tell you. You and Boo both. It may shock you both to know, but Minsk and this Stone Lord, they are one man. The same one man. And that same one man is Minsk. Never has Boo been more proud of my failures. I wish to believe the Stone Lord's evil was the worm alone, attainting my thoughts with foul dung. But I see now the dung was within Minsk all along. So I wonder if Minsk can be a villain and Nine Fingers a hero. Must it be so with all creatures? Is there good and evil within us all? Boo calls this nonsense. Less thinking of bad thoughts, says he, and more breaking of bad bones. But still, I would hear what you have to say on the matter, my friend. Of course, one look into his beady little eyes should be enough to tell Minsk there is pure and untainted goodness in this world. Oh, thank you, my friend. As ever, I shall do only what my heart and hamster tell me to. Kill the villains! Kill them all! Break them beneath my boots, no matter how they squeal for mercy! I feel better. Minsk is ready to go and do some butt-kicking!
Very well.
Voss stands at the ready. All that remains is to return to the Astral Prism and break Orpheus free. How we get in remains to be seen.
Better not be cursed.
Mm-hmm.
My fortune!
Next.
Ready and willing.
Flackett's will be done.
Can't give up now. Wonder if the gods are watching me. Bet that'll fit in my pack. Here goes nothing.
It's that.
Baldurin, with a bronze dragon.
Must have been quite an adventure. Baldurin and his winged ally admiring the fruits of their labor. The city itself. Baldurin sails away and leaves the dragon to watch over his city. Do the histories make mention of this?
The statue before you bears a familiar likeness. It is Baldurin, the celebrated adventurer who founded the city of Baldur's Gate.
Peril floods my province. The palisades fall, the earth does tremble. The servants of shadow and blood assemble. Beyond lies the grand worm, deep in slumber, awaiting a true hero's advent, should my domain drown in torment. Be you the deluge, turn away. Be you the hero, answer true. Are you worthy?
Poetic nonsense. There is no worm and no savior.
Neither life nor spirit within the statue. A powerful variant of magic mouth has been cast on it, allowing it to speak only recorded messages. The statue gives no response.
Ancient Ansor, hear me. A champion is proclaimed. The test begins. Let your judgment follow.
Incredible. How old is this place?
I'll take that. Paintings hung on the wall. Almost like an art gallery.
A true champion knows justice and eliminates those who stand in its way. Restore the balance of justice.
Thank you.
the apple. The painting depicts a red-haired man stealing a shiny apple from a cart in an open-air market. You know this market, the wide, where Baldur's Gate citizens and visitors gather to conduct trade and wax political. The child. A red-haired man is portrayed with his cloak's hood lowered, giving an apple to a smiling urchin. Several other children are huddled behind the one receiving the apple, hands outstretched. The induction. A red-haired man is depicted in hushed conversation with a dark-haired woman. She wears a cloak with an unusual symbol on it, tally marks totaling the number 9. The theft. A red-haired man is depicted in the Hall of Wonders, thieving what looks to be a priceless artifact. It's an astrolabe of entrapment. It could hold a dozen djinn within it, perhaps even more. The chase. A red-haired man is depicted running through the city streets, a flaming fist officer chasing just behind. A cloaked woman, hair dark as a raven, looks on from a safe distance. The judgment. A stern judge, his pockets full of coin, orders a red-haired man to the gallows. A shiny apple rests on the ground nearby.
Seems like a good moment to talk.
Away! Behold, the paintings tell the tale. My judgment is rendered. The thief earns his due.
The shadows are blocking me. I need to get rid of them somehow. Thank you.
Let's get on with it.
No time to rest.
Wits and blades, always sharp.
No one stopped me yet. Need to find a way forward. Let's see what this does.
A champion burns bright, even when rushing waters and moaning winds threaten to extinguish the flames. Take the torch, withstand the elements, prove your courage.
Heading there.
Come on, can't stay idle. Swim!
Perillo!
Fury.
Violence breeds madness. Attack her.
Might just be the hardest of all.
For me.
Prove your strategic wits. There is but one rule. The Dark King must fall in two moves. Are you a commander of armies, or a shivering pawn, fodder for cleverer minds?
Lanceboard happens to be a game with which I have more than a passing familiarity. Might I offer a suggestion? First, have the White Queen move all the way across and capture the Black Pawn. This leaves Black's King in check, forcing him to retreat a square left. Your Queen then takes the other pawn, one square up and left, always under the protection of her faithful Bishop.
Wicked, be they pawn, knight, or monarch. Proceed.
Whatever it takes.
We're a long way from Waterdeep.
I've got a long road ahead. Don't waste a step.
good leader has the insight to find good counsel. As a war reaches its end, there is one who doesn't advise for the city's prosperity. Find him and strike him down.
Still, will you?
Damn thing could just slow down a moment.
Almost. A long way to go still.
Let's get going.
swift as my feet can carry me. To put my hands on everything.
My faith will guide me.
Imperial. I've a lot on my mind and, well, in it. Open up. How much farther can I go?
Strike down the advisor who would lead the city to ruin. decision. The Tree of Peace bore lasting fruit. Proceed.
I should speak up.
No! The judge has spoken. The crime must be punished!
Whatever comes, I'm ready. Injuries begone.
Stay up, Zora!
At least things have stayed interesting.
The hanging. A red-haired man is depicted hanging from a gallows as a crowd looks on. You notice a child in the crowd, a falling tear leaving a trail on his cheek. Freedom. A red-haired man walks the streets of Baldur's Gate, clad in a billowing cloak. You catch a glimpse of a sly smile beneath his hood and a golden coin in his hand. The cell. A stern prison guard slides a warm meal into the thief's cell. The red-haired man has a 10-day left to serve, judging by the scratchings on the wall behind him. The hanging. A red-haired man is depicted hanging from a gallows as a crowd looks on. You notice a child in the crowd, a falling tear leaving a trail on his cheek.
Maybe I need more pockets. Keep going. give it a shot.
Prison guard slides a warm meal into the thief's cell. The red-haired man has a 10-day left to serve, judging by the scratchings on the wall behind him.
I wonder what the next move is.
At the ready.
Never a dull moment.
I am ready.
Looking ahead. Let's see.
With courage does the hero march. Fettered by the taxing chains of fear, a stalwart soul must ever persevere. With insight does the hero choose. Guidance born of ancient wisdom proven. Peace, not strife, the undenied conclusion. With justice does the hero rule. Lead not the guiltless lamb to bloody slaughter, nor cleanse the lion's sins in sacred water. With strategy does the hero scheme. A cunning mind, 100 steps ahead, your allies close, your rivals stunned in dread. Worthy you are found. Go forth, hero, seize your fate, and rise, great worm, heart of the gate.
What am I to do?
No rest for the wicked, I see.
I shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times.
For battle.
Still alive, so that's progress. Moving in.
Hells. The great worm is nothing but bone and memories.
What's hiding here?
They're not yours, but the worms.
I am Ansar, heart of the gate, butchered in flesh, risen in spirit.
Ansar wends his way through your mind like an unstoppable river. Your body is unmoving, yet thought flows effortlessly between you. The spirit pauses, and you feel the astral prism stir. Ansar senses the Emperor's presence within it.
Answer me, Facey. Why have you come?
Resonates within you. The torrent stills, only disturbed by the dragon's next words.
Brack, my words aren't meant for you. They're meant for him.
The Emperor stirs in the astral prism, then in you. Calm, curious, and detached.
Your presence has stirred me, as it ever did. I am awakened.
Ansar, it's been too long.
A name I once answered to. A name I did not expect to hear again. Least of all from the mouth of an old friend. Friend. Yes. And more. Until you killed me. Have you come to dance on my bones, Balduran? Was slaying me not satisfaction enough? Satisfaction? No. You left me no choice. You had every choice. You were becoming illithid. I offered you merciful death. You chose to fight. And now you bring your thrall before me. How far has the great Balduran fallen?
Stillness. Ansur's consciousness hovers just above yours, searching, seeing.
Dear Ansur.
Enough!
I gave you everything, Balduran. And you repaid me in slaughter. It is time I return the favor. Let my bones rise and the storms gather. Witness, Balduran. The final tempest has come. I am the heart of the gate. I am the one who roars. This time, you will not escape it.
Thank you.
danse macabre.
I won't give in.
Let's light them up.
Oh. in my best interest.
Now, I am much, much more. But it seems you are more interested in my past. Such sentimentality. Very well. It's like I always told you. I was just like you. An adventurer who yearned for greatness. And in mortal terms, I achieved it. As captain of the Wandering Eye, I acquired enough gold to found Baldur's Gate. I stayed for a while to watch my city grow. But it was not enough. I grew restless again. The sea called to me, and I ran to her with open arms. Life at sea was not easy. Our last adventure was ruinous. My ship was destroyed. My crew lost. But my spirit was far from broken. I was determined to return in triumph once again. I heard of treasure in Moonrise. I strove to find it. What I found was an illithid colony, where I acquired a tadpole much like yours, and became a mind flayer, enthralled to the Elder Brain. It was Ansor who found me. Ansor who pulled me from the Brain's domination. Ansor who brought me home. He sought to cure me of my sickness, called on every healer he could find, nearly broke his spirit in the attempt. But he failed to understand. I wanted no healing. I was not sick. Even after he had exhausted all possibility of reversing my condition, he still clung to hope. I tried to convince him of my reality. I was on the cusp of greatness beyond my wildest dreams. But all he could see was a mind flayer. He came to me as I slept. A mercy killing in his mind. I saw the tears. I felt his grief. I had no choice but to kill him first. It was an act of self-preservation. Put simply, yes. And being alive, even more so. Do not think that I am ignorant of what I have lost. I may not regret my actions, but I do regret that they were necessary. While the past is beyond my influence, the present is not. It is time we move on. Two Netherstones remain in the hands of the Chosen. We must find them before we confront the Brain.
Should mind my step. No one back home will ever believe this. Best be on my way.
Blackets will be done.
Objective noted.
Let's move. Another step forward.
The worm's tempest and his roar hurtle through you. Ansu's essence still lives within the helm, instilling you with power for as long as you wear it.
Oh, enough waiting. I crave blood.
Still alive, so that's progress. Time to press ahead. A private word would be nice.
Is something burdening you?
I failed. The heart of the gate is dead. We need to see my father. He should know what happened with Ansel. The Absolute's voice is gone, but I still hear its echoes. Reflections of reflections. I failed, Father. The worm is fallen. A terrible fate for Ansel, my son. Yet my hopes for the city's future have never been higher.
I don't understand.
You and your allies slayed the undead terror that was once the Great Ansel. You are stronger than even the Great Worm. You will be the one to part the storms and lead the people through. You, not Ansel, are the savior we need. First, you will fell the Absolute. Then we will rebuild Baldur's Gate, We will take back our city together. I will name you Baldur's Gate's newest Grand Duke of the Council. You will be hailed Heart of the Gate.
Grand Duke? I look the part of a fiend.
I will tell the citizens and the patriarchs of your good works. They will know you carry your father's banner.
Uncertainty fills the air. Will has reached a fork in his path. In which direction will he travel?
Will?
I fought to right the wrongs of the coast, to slay the men and monsters that hunt the helpless.
It is in the wilds that I find my courage, not in the halls of Upper City Estates.
There will be no Grand Duke Will Ravengard, and there will be no Blade of Frontiers.
I am now the Blade of Avernus. For as long as demons and devils imperil the Sword Coast, they will be my prey.
Then go with my blessing. Be Faerun's great defender. Courage, insight, strategy, justice. Let these be the lights that guide you, my son. Hail the Blade of Avernus!
The Blade of Avernus!
A calm settles over you. The Elder Brain is a menace, but with the Blade of Avernus at your side, you know you can triumph.
The Blade of Avernus. A new name for a changed man.
The four pillars finally rise within me. Courage, insight, strategy, justice. I'm not to abide them, but to become them.
Ah, but enough reflection for today. I'm of a mind to celebrate. A hearty meal would do the trick. A few hunks of fresh venison, a round of brown ale. What do you say? Of course, but we need nourishment, don't we? And we can't go beating up brains on empty stomachs.
You hunt the meat, I'll scrounge up the ale. Prepare your belly for a roast a la Blade.
Let's hope Gale doesn't take offense if I assume cooking duties, just the once.
I scout both the Hells and the Coast's Havens, and I destroy every fiend that dares put its eye on Faerun.
Will takes a sharp breath. He's keeping something from you.
Yes, there is.
I will be hunting Mazora. I won't let her claim one more soul, slay one more victim. I'm going to make my way to the Hells and tear the horns right off her damned head. Father trained me in the sword and the bow. They'll have to sustain me.
Damn right. I'll cut her to ribbons before she can so much as groan Zariel's name.
The Blade of Avernus. How marvelous. It rolls right off the tongue. Tell me, little bug, who should Will's first target be? Yes, to kill the Absolute, to free the infected, to end the illithid grand design. Could there be a more heroic journey? But what about the next battle? And the next? How mighty will the stalwart Blade be without warlock powers to help him? Tell me you haven't forgotten. Once the Absolute is no more, so is my aid. Well, perhaps I might pay a visit once he's settled. Offer some advice. A bit of infernal altruism, if you will. The thrill of the unknown. I can't wait to see how this epic plays out.
The Devil's Stench lingers, but Will is yet a champion of the people. I'd hoped he'd join me on the council, but he is his own man. I couldn't be prouder. Gods, can it be? The man who raised the city's walls became an illithid.
You both know you owe your lives to me. I am not fallen. I am risen.
We must make this a secret we carry beyond the grave. No name is more sacred to the city than Balduran's. Not even mine. When people think his name or see his likeness, they must imagine a hero. Not a horror.
How misguided you are.
So Will's the Blade of Avernus now. I suppose that's a new sort of frontier for him.
Do you feel that? The Hells themselves tremble to face such a scourge as Will threatens to be. The Blade of Avernus, forged by a Cambion, whetted on a dragon's hide. Those devils won't know what's coming for them.
Whatever happens next, be sure that I will document it all as accurately as possible.
Fate spins along as it should.
Dost thou require a new ally? Or mayhaps a resurrection instead?
The Blade of Avernus. I can't think of a better man than Will to take up the title. It's about time someone stood up to the evil fucks populating the Hells.
The Blade of Avernus. I suppose Hell is just another frontier. Will shall force all devilkind to tremble before him. The Hells have much to fear.
A noble chant, is it not? Hail Will! Blade of Avernus! Well, yes, Boo, the horseless chariots of Avernus are impressive too. But that would be no kind of name, would it?
I'll give it a shot.